top left drawer, eye drops, go to town.
These focus groups usually pay really well, actually. The technology ones, because probably have the most money, too, you know? Mm-hmm. They're the ones that have the best. And they ask you these general questions.
Keep going.
But they don't tell you if it's Samsung or Apple, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It might not even be about a cell phone, to be honest.
Can you give me a short list of things on your New York City bucket list?
I've never been to the Statue of Liberty.
Oh, look at that. Does this shirt say spring break?
You have so much good comedy there.
He's hitting his own face with his boobs.
Caroline's is great.
So have you ever been to a concert in a park?
Barbara Streisand, when she did Central Park.
That had to be millions of people, a million people.
Oh, there have always been millions of people there. I mean, I just, the end of it was open.
Farting bubbles.
My last concert in Central Park was Sting.
Yeah, who's Sting?
Wow, Murray held strong.
Yeah.
Look at Joe's face, so contemplative.
In Central Park. Then there was, and it's
All right. Miss, you just came from that direction. Did you see what went? I'm a reporter from the Staten Island Retreat. I got sent to cover the story. My editor sent me down, I missed it. And I was wondering if you could just give me a quote about it.
I didn't see anything.
Yeah, but that's okay. That's all right. The story, look.
I don't even know the story.
No, I'll tell you the story, they told me it again. It was a tall woman makes tacos with no hands. Right there in the park. I just needed to say this was a tragedy all around and it made me sick. Would you mind just saying that?
No.
You don't mind saying it?
No, I do mind saying it. I don't even know what you're talking about.
It was a tall woman and she made tacos with no hands. Would you eat tacos from a woman that made it with her mouth or her feet? You wouldn't, right?
No, I wouldn't.
Right, so that was a tragedy all around, we might say. And it definitely would make you sick. So
but
you
I don't know if that's even true.
This was a tragedy.
Harass another person.
Oh, this isn't harass. Don't we became friends?
So I'll be training you today.
Bring some flair to this place. Like flip stuff in the air and catch it.
So you have your mangoes. You do the same amount of pineapples.
This is fun. I feel like a bartender.
Woo! Keep doing it.
Good. Got it.
We'll do tricks later on. It also has spinach and kale.
Do a trick.
That's it.
Just put it inside.
Boom, like a spin.
You're obsessed with doing tricks, dude.
That's enough. Over the shoulder. Great.
Oh, man, you know there's a bathroom here? Is there a bathroom in this?
Here we go.
I can't take the dog. Do you mind just sitting with her for a minute for me?
Great. Yeah, she's great.
Her name's Smelly Ripper.
It's only because I have a crush on Kelly Ripa, and she farts like a lot.
Because I have a huge crush on host Kelly Ripa, and she farts a lot, though.
The dog farts, not Kelly Ripa.
The dog farts a lot, not Kelly Ripa. Okay? I'll be right back.
There's no way the guy's saying it. Here we go.
There you go.
Boy, girl, what's her name?
Some kind of Kelly.
Some kind of Kelly
something? Some kind of Kelly something?
Do you know why he named it what he did?
No.
No.
Oh, it's done.
Hiya, Papa. Hiya, baby. Thank you so much. It's my girl, Smelly Ripper.
Smelly Ripper.
I call Smelly Ripper because I love TV personality Kelly Ripper, and this dog farts a lot. Smelly Ripper.
You know what I think about that? Do you hear about the corduroy pillowcases, Joe?
You got corduroy pillowcases?
Yeah, they're making headlines everywhere.
Very good.
I mean, Joe, when this guy passes you, just say to him, show me that fuzzy.
Oh, show me that fuzzy. Huh? Oh, my bad. I said, show me that fuzzy.
Oh, crap, you're not Carl.
Oh, crap, you're not Carl.
No.
I bet you don't even have a fuzzy.
I bet you don't even have a fuzzy.
Excuse me, can you do me a favor? Could you take a picture of me?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Thank you so much. I just want to do one quick selfie.
Yeah.
There you go.
Oh, Joe, so close.
Should I, is it kneeling good or no?
Get him, Joe.
Oh,
if we just see the, if we turn it sideways, you want to hold on a second? If we turn it sideways, then I can get like the whole thing. And I'll stand this time.
Oh, he's here. That was just close.
I don't know what he's doing, but that's funny. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right. Thanks, guys. Really, I appreciate you taking the time. But I know there's a lot of stuff.
I got him at the buzzer! He got him at the buzzer!
Well, you can't beat this weather, you know what I'm saying? It's totally enjoyable.
Yeah. Agree or disagree?
Agree or disagree with me?
Gandhi probably snuck in some potato chips during that hunger strike.
Gandhi. The Indian peace, the peace warlord in India?
The peace warlord.
You know the hunger strike he did?
Yes.
Agree or disagree? He probably snuck in a couple of potato chips on that hunger strike, right? Because he did a lot of good things, Gandhi, and I'm all for peace, and I think he did a great, he's probably the best warlord that India ever had. But if you're gonna say you do a hunger strike, you know, lay off the chips. I don't care who you are. I love peace. You dangle a kettle chip in front of someone, they're eating it, you know? He probably snuck one or two in that hunger strike, right? Yeah, you were great. You were great. Thank you, bro. Thank you very much. Do you need anything else?
Okay, here we go.
No, that's it.
Just that?
All right, let's send in the actor.
Okay, it's $4.95.
It's Rob Emmer!
You may know Rob Emmer.
Rob's been in our show a bunch.
I'll take an everything bagel with cream cheese.
Could you stand right here? Thanks.
That's not your actor. Your actor, the guy's to the left. That's just Rob Emmer who came in to offer a bottle.
Rob, come here. I'm sorry. I thought you were someone else. I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
I'm so sorry. All right.
It's all good.
Okay. Did they just tell you to come in the store?
Yeah.
They didn't tell you why or what for?
We didn't know. We didn't tell them anything.
Yeah, do me a favor, Rob. Go throw this in that guy's face for me. Go throw this in. I'm sorry. I meant to get him, not you. Go throw it in that guy's face.
I'm sorry. He meant to get you, not me.
Okay. Better.
That's not the actor! That's not the actor! That's not the actor! This guy was chopping!
What did you do? Why did you tell me that?
I'm gonna walk out now.
Oh my God. Why would you guys do that?
No, it's our actor.
It doesn't stop! It doesn't stop!
There we go. Let's do it. Sal, shimmy quickly around the corner. You're scared to death, bud.
I'm good, yeah.
Just come hold my hand.
Just hold my hand. Q, ask him if he minds if you listen to your podcast. Do you listen to podcasts?
Yeah, sometimes.
Hit the iPad. It's an Italian podcast called Faccia Bella by Two Paisans. Do you ever listen to, there's an Italian podcast. It's Faccia Bella by Two Paisans.
Okay, no.
Oh, it's awesome. Here we go.
Maestro Giovannato.
Here you go, Q. Dude, make believe you understand it and that it's hysterical.
Do you know this? Do you know Italian? Oh my God, hold on, listen.
They're both wearing bright pants.
They're both wearing bright pants. And they didn't mean to.
They're running out of air in a fallout shelter.
Oh, God. They're running out of air in a fallout shelter.
But all they can talk about is a can of tuna.
All they can talk about, they got fighting over this can of tuna. He's bringing up the time that he sneezed into his mouth at a ball of some sort.
Do you speak Italian?
No, not really. Certain words. I know bright and pants, sneeze, mouth, fallout shelter, and I know tuna. She slept with his son for payback for a bad haircut. Yeah, loses some in the translation.
Hey, how are you, sir?
I wanted to find out about business card.
Remind him that you have the right to review service.
We're gonna get you a couple of specs for that. You can do different finishes and stuff like that. I will remind you though, at any time, we do have the right to refuse service.
Yeah, at any time.
Why would you do that?
It's just a policy that we have in case things start going in a way that we don't appreciate.
Explain to them the longest promotional deal in the world and do it at the same time.
It's basically a fall special.
Yeah. So if you want to deliver them online, as long as it's done by
October 31st,
you can get them to come
month,
through. We deliver them down the street.
An order of 500
get them,
or 30%
and it's
off. An order of
20-40% off.
He is thoroughly confused.
Tell them about the rebate.
There is a rebate.
So you can mail in rebate.
In store. and mail-in, you could choose
both,
which one that you like.
Both a mail-in and in-store rebate right now.
Okay. keep going.
You can put them like
with different fonts and
musicians that
well.
Put them on guitar picks,
right,
or we just cut it
their business
to look like a different
more
thing and stand out.
Well,
some of the business cards pop out. The entire catalog's on there,
and that's 10-15% off an order of 500 or more. And you want to buy October 31st. That's really the point.
Well, I'll take a look at this.
Yeah, just as a reminder, we have the right to refuse service.
I will check that out.
Yeah. Okay,
thank you.
agree or disagree?
Sports magazines should be scratch and sniff.
Sports magazines should be scratch and sniff. I mean, look, you're reading the magazine, you see, you gotta go. Do you agree? Excuse me, sir, can I ask you a question? I just need your honest opinion. Agree or disagree?
Everything is just a hole you haven't dug yet.
Everything is just a hole you haven't dug yet. Am I right about that or what?
Okay, I gotta go.
Okay, Dave Sal's turn. I gotta go. That's what everybody's
okay,
saying.
Okay, I gotta go.
Hand on the shoulder. Okay, gotta go. Okay, gotta go.
How bad would you guys feel if this place is about to get robbed and they come and they're like, okay, first we gotta kill the security guard?
Would we air it?
What's up, bro?
So, Sal, say I'm the manager and I fired Blake because his ass doesn't stock the cola right.
Just so you know, I'm the manager. And I don't know if you come in here a lot, but I fire Blake because his ass don't know how to stock the cola.
Actually, I do need a soda too, so.
Well, Blake didn't stock it.
Yes. It's a stock now.
It is now, but Blake's ass don't know how to stock cola, so I had to get rid of Blake's ass. I'm the manager. That was the number one thing on my list for him. Stock the cola, Blake. Hey, Blake, you stock the cola? What's going on there, Blake? Because that's one of your main jobs, Blake. Well, I don't stock the cola well. Well, you know what, Blake? Your ass don't know how to stock the cola. You ain't going to be working here no longer, Blake.
In Blake's defense, I thought he stocked the soda pretty well.
Sal, that's not what you wanted to hear, buddy.
Listen, it's not hard to stock cola, okay? Blake didn't stock the cola well. I told you that.
All I'm saying is...
I don't want to hear anything...
Watch out, you're next.
Blake stocked the soda just fine.
I can't believe this. I'm the only one trying to steer this blimpy ship in the right direction. If it wasn't for me, this blimpy ship would be going down. As far as blimpy is concerned, I am God.
Just once more in Blake's defense.
Enough with Blake.
You want some?
No, I'm good, thanks.
I got a water if you want.
No, I'm good.
Yeah?
If you're in the mood for a urine sample, we got a cooler full of them right next to you.
Well, if you're in the mood for a urine sample, I got a cooler full of them right over there, right next to you.
Also, if you want to add to the collection, feel free to take a piss in the cooler.
Also, if you want to add to the collection, I mean, you can just, you know, take a peeps in the cooler right there.
What's so amusing?
What was, I heard you, kind of... snicker a little bit. What was so amusing?
The urine sample, please.
Oh, okay. I thought I missed a joke. Got it. There's no way we get a free car from anybody, is there?
You're the Movado guy. You might get a free Movado.
No way. Dude, 8 years in, and we still haven't yet to get a free anything.
We're way over it.
Guys, let's take 30 seconds right now to address the camera and tell them we've been on TV for nearing a decade. If anybody wants to send us anything free, all the way from a scoop of ice cream to a Range Rover, please. We're here.
You going to meet a friend? You're on your way to work?
Yeah, no, I just meeting my buddy.
Meeting your buddy.
Oh, and then what?
Yeah. Then what are you guys doing?
I don't know, but he's hanging out, maybe go for drinks or something.
Oh, cool. Then what?
Then what?
Just the hell out of me, then the trek back to Manhattan.
Then what?
Not a hell of a lot.
Don't play hijinks. What's wrong with you? You that strong? You that strong?
He's got a stock on his. We're getting delirious.
I know. It's weird. It looks like you're wearing a bald cap.
This is what I'm going to look like in a few years.
Do you imagine that the series is over and Murray's like, oh, that's it, guys, it's over? And he takes off a bald cap and he's like, oh, here we go. Here we go. Act natural. Seven.
Yeah. I'm okay. I'm trying to learn things.
Nessie, I'm so sorry if I'm a little slow.
I'm so sorry I'm a little slow.
A f***ing pelican hit me in the temple the other day.
What?
Pelican hit me in my temple the other day, and I haven't been right since. I was down there in Staten Island, and a pelican came out of nowhere and hit my temple, and I had a hard time concentrating. You ever see a pelican? They're not cute.
No, they're not.
They got giant gullets.
Stupid question.
If this is a stupid question,
no,
just
no, stupid
let me
know. Go ahead.
But I want to add a gradient that changes the color of the lower half of the text image.
I want to add like a gradient that horizontally changes the lower half of the text.
And creates an opaque transition.
Like an opaque transition.
Between the background
between
and the top.
The background and the top.
Can we do that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We're going to do that.
Okay.
Yes.
How do you even know those words?
I don't.
Okay.
So I could do shapes. Oh, so this is something I've seen people do where they'll just, oh, look how many.
Just list everything that you see in that drop-down menu.
Oh, wow, there's a square, and there's a circle, triangle, trapezoid, a diamond, a seven-sided figure, an eight-sided figure. Oh, then there's arrows, too. I could do a left arrow.
And then you draw how big you want the
Get
arrow.
Get the out of here.
Exactly.
Amazed. You're amazed.
Look at that. So now, any, so if I wanted to add more, if I want.
The mouse pad.
You know how to use these charts and tables?
Yeah, it depends on what you're going for, a bar, kind of bar chart or line graph.
Definitely a bar chart, that's the most fun.
Well, statistically speaking, people have a lot of fun with bar charts.
Against the pie chart, I mean, who's gonna look at a pie chart? What am I, an asshole?
Compared to a pie chart? Who the hell uses a pie chart? I'm not an asshole, I'm not gonna use a pie chart.
Now replace chart with chart.
How do you insert the pie chart?
The pie chart's under a insert as well.
Yeah, try to insert, I wanna see what a bar chart looks like.
I'm familiar with bar charts.
Bar charts, I'm familiar with bar charts.
I used to party a lot in college.
I used to party a lot in college.
Yeah.
This is so stupid.
Yeah. Murr, see the guy with the gray hat? Just tap him on the arm and be like, check out my wife. Check out my wife. She's gorgeous, right?
Yeah, she might kill you, man.
check this out.
She
looks like she's out of my league, right?
She looks, I'll tell you this, she looks like she's out of my league.
You haven't seen her foot.
The tail on or the tail off?
Well, let's go tail off. But you haven't seen her foot.
It is.
Gross. It is a train wreck down there.
You keep rubbing them.
Yeah, I will.
All right, Jerry.
All right, let's see. Good day, let's get a, maybe I'll get a hazelnut latte, who knows? Nothing's gonna ruin my day.
Hey, pardon me, miss. You are our 100th customer, so we're giving out a $10 gift card. Congratulations.
Really?
What the f***?
$10? American?
$10 American?
Yeah, I love you.
That's amazing. I got no luck, though. It's fine. That's the story of my life.
My parents are throwing me out of the house this week.
My parents are throwing me out of my house this week.
Really?
Yeah. Well, it's their house.
So my parents can't take my IBS.
I do get where my parents come from, though, because, you know, they have to battle with the IBS the whole time. My IBS.
I'm dripping from places that aren't holes.
Enjoy your gift card. I hope you.
Are you done?
I can't say that to a person.
Excuse me. No disrespect. No disrespect.
Your teeth don't match your lips.
Your teeth don't match your lips. We good? We good? We good? We good? Yeah, we good. We good.
That's good. Oh my God, that was a we good at the buzzer.
Wow, nice.
Excuse me, sir. No disrespect, but
your face is the worst part of my day.
No disrespect whatsoever. Just, I'm not having a great day.
No, no disrespect.
No disrespect. But you're. I'm in a moment right now. I'm stuck in a moment. I'm trying to get out of it. I'm not sure how to do it.
Let me give you a little Joe Skunge soundtrack to help you.
We're good.
All right, we're good. For no reason.
Yes.
Excuse me. Excuse me. No disrespect.
You probably just sweep, right? You don't vacuum.
You probably just sweep, right? You don't vacuum.
I'm sorry?
Like, you probably just sweep. You don't vacuum.
Are you asking about my house?
Like, you know, in general. No disrespect. But you probably just sweep. You don't vacuum.
I have a vacuum.
You do?
Yeah.
Oh, we good, though? We good?
We good.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Ah! All right, you're on the board.
Excuse me. Sorry. No disrespect.
No bank's giving you mortgage. Come on.
But this is ridiculous. Have a good day. Sorry. I can't do this. Oh, yes. Here we go. What do we got? I got one.
No, it's the menu. So they got it up top. Oh, yeah, take it. So you know. Oh, no disrespect.
You're way prettier than my wife.
No, I'm sad because I didn't know that.
100%. Yeah. Oh, we good. You too, man.
All right, now you know how it feels.
That's it. You got it. That's a good one.
Gonna have you right here.
Sal, measure super fast, bud.
Okay, so let me just see. So you're 32 there. That's gonna be about 32.
Don't even look. Don't see even your head the other way.
That looks like it's about 28.
Jeez, you're good at this.
You're good at this?
Been doing this since I was born. 40. 20.
So the back doesn't match the front?
It's actually odd because your back is actually half the front. But this is a stretch fit, so you're fine.
This is a floor to remember. You're having a bad day, someone's died, someone's broke up with you. Now you have an entire floor just to remember.
Tell them to go home and cry.
Well, we are really kind of trying to soften the edges of the workspace.
And these millennials come to work and cry all day.
I'm a millennial, so.
Oh. You're a millennial? What millennia?
Sal, claim you're 28. I'm 28 years old. What are you going to do? I'll be on the floor to remember. I'll meet you later.
Yeah.
Planet Bollywood, right? Coming to fourth floor.
Planet Bollywood.
More inclusive, you know, more diversive.
Yeah.
What is diversive? Is that a word?
We're pleased to announce this popular rock and roll meets Indian celeb culture restaurant chain is coming to the fourth floor. Will not affect Planet Hollywood, which is on 5. I don't know if you guys know when they launched Planet Hollywood, they had Arnold Schwarzenegger used to pop in on them as like it was a thing that became known. So we're hoping to do the same thing with some big Bollywood names.
Yeah.
Such as?
Priyanka Chopra. We have a call out too.